Hi, my name is Bert Johnson. I have the pleasure of serving as the Director of Music here at Spring Valley United Methodist Church. As you may know by now, we are entering into a season of stewardship. As we enter this season, we'll be exploring the four different vision points of the vision at Spring Valley. The first one being creating compelling worship. One of the things I love about my job is that everything I do during a given week or a given day has to do with compelling worship. Whether it's working with the adult choir or the gospel choir, or working with our McKinster fellows or our children and youth, or serving as a resource for Common Ground or in leadership for all of the technical components of our worship, like streaming or our screens or sound. What I really love is the creative aspect of worship planning. It all starts with Paul setting a theme for a season or a sermon series. These are anchored in Scripture, and they help us to focus over an extended period of time or weeks. I will get to work picking out music for the choir. Anthems will be selected 5 to 8 weeks ahead of time. And then we gather for worship meeting every week. Paul, myself, Rose Danny, John, our organist, and Sharon, our church administrator, we gather every week to sort out the musical choices for the congregation for that particular week and the weeks to follow. We also will discuss logistical needs. Common Ground will also meet on a regular basis to help discover their needs in worship. Well, why do we spend so much time in this process? We hope to create an environment that is a clear path for a worshiper, one that puts the worshiper at ease. We hope to provide a thread that ties these ideas of the day in a way that will resonate a wide variety of worshipers as well. We can do all of this and still not be successful. We need partners in this process, and our partners are you. We hope that worshipers will come with open minds that are willing to close out the world around them for one short hour without unrealistic expectations. When I was a young musician, I served in New York City as a pro chorister, and one of those appointments was at Marble Collegiate Church. Marble Collegiate is a big, affluent church in Midtown Manhattan and is the oldest congregation in this country. Its pulpit was home to one of the most famous author and speakers, Norman Vincent Peale, and I really loved preaching. It was one of the things that I cherished most out of worship. But I would come to church every week with huge expectations of what I was going to get out of the sermon that day. And I was always disappointed. You see, Marble was a church with a nationally syndicated TV broadcast. Their message was created for a much broader audience. And it is true that the sermons were very surface level for that specific reason. And one day I realized I needed an attitude change. Instead of coming to worship with the expectation of what I was going to get out of it, how about coming to worship with the expectation of what I could give? I began to focus my energies to outward directed praise to God. And that began a transformational journey of worship for me. Today I want to challenge you. During the course of our worship today, you will hear and sing the word Alleluia many times. Alleluia, translated simply, means may the name of the Lord be praised. I invite you to use that word as a tool to open your hearts and focus your mind, body, and spirit upon the outward and directed act of worship. Discover for yourself what difference it can make for you. I pray that you will continue in your faithfulness to give to the great vision of this wonderful church. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to worshiping with you.
Of our loving Lord, grace that exceeds our sin and our guilt, yonder on Calvary's mount outpoured, there where the blood of the Lamb was spilled. Grace, grace, God's grace, grace that will pardon and cleanse within. Grace, grace, God's grace, grace that is greater than all our sin. Marvelous, infinite, matchless grace, freely bestowed on all who believe. You who are longing to see face, will you this moment his grace receive?